In this section, we will take a look at the different ways to optimise the ship's routing and harbour manoeuvring ability, which could save as much as 25% of the fuel consumption. Optimal speed is the speed at which the ship is most economical to run, and this relies on a number of factors, such as profit and expenses, and especially full expenditures. The most important energy conservation can be achieved by reducing the ship's speed. Unfortunately, this also reduces the ship's transportation capacity. The optimal ship's speed is found by analysing the actual cargo market and how profit can be obtained from various speeds. In addition, fuel, crew and maintenance expenses have to be added. Once a route is established, it is best to respect it and reach the destination at the scheduled time. The time spent in harbour has to be optimised by finding the ship's best loading and unloading procedures. Keeping up a continuous load output saves fuel. The previous example shows clearly what an uneven speed costs in fuel consumption. However, this must be weighted against the eventual loss in time for arriving at a destination at the wrong time. Harbour manoeuvres should be done with progressive and moderate accelerations, if the conditions allow for it. Any hard manoeuvre is a strain on the engine and a waste of fuel. Ships with variable pitch propellers risk facing up to 50% increased fuel consumption due to a wrongly adjusted pitch. As a rule, an optimal engine load is achieved by low RPM, high pitch, adjusting the speed by engine RPM. Well-designed ship propulsion will display its lowest specific fuel consumption when the propeller pitch is least changed in relation to full load. On the other hand, if the RPM is kept the same when the output is reduced, the specific consumption will increase in proportion to the optimal. In one example, two alternatives are plotted. The first, with fixed RPM and reduced pitch, the second with reduced RPM and fixed pitch. From this, we can see that the gain or loss of fuel consumption increases as the load decreases. For all practical purposes, the upper and lower limits of the propeller shaft speed will be dictated by the engine's thermal and mechanical specifications. Ships equipped with a combinator will benefit from an automatic adjustment of the pitch and RPM. It is advisable to check the function of the combinator with regards to what has been stated above.